Tucked away in Toronto's Hillcrest Village is a resource and training center for immigrants and refugees. In order to serve Toronto's growing community in a larger capacity, Skills for Change sought the help of CAKE when it came to funding much-needed renovations and increasing its overall workspace.
The CAKE loan was very important to us because it enabled us. We own our property, and obviously when you own a property, there's an awful lot of responsibility that comes along with that, and there's an awful lot of cost that goes into maintaining the building. And so the loan really enabled us to kind of enhance the capacity of the building, which has been wonderful in terms of everybody's experience of the organization. I would describe Skills for Change as a place where immigrants and refugees can come to get the skills and information they need to work in the community. And so specifically we offer language training courses, skills upgrading courses, and employment preparation programs. And we particularly specialize in programs for internationally educated professionals. So for example, we have a program for teachers, we have a program for medical doctors, program for engineers, so it's quite specialized. We have some more general programs as well, but what we're sort of known for and what is really the draw for people to Skills for Change is that we do have very tailored programs, and we're successful at helping people get into jobs in their profession. We have about 10,000 clients a year. On average, our success rate is about 70% of people do find work in their field. Another people after 3 to 6 months. That's a success rate that we're very happy with, and we're always looking at ways to make sure that 70% is 70%. That those are really good jobs that people are getting. That people are getting jobs in their field that really reflect their skills and ability.
I started doing some volunteering for other organizations, but that's how I got to learn about Skills for Change and about all the services and support that they provide to internationally skilled immigrants. So I was particularly interested in job search workshop, and that's what I attended. But yeah, the help I received was tremendous in many ways. They were holding a networking event here at Skills for Change, and I attended this event, and I ended up chatting with my future boss at that time, Jane Cullingworth. I didn't know who she was. We just ended up sitting next to each other and we got into a conversation, and she said that they were looking for an assistant, so why don't I apply? And at that time I just started searching, so it took me 3 weeks altogether. I applied for the position and went for an interview, and today I am very happy to be a part of Skills for Change family.
There's an individual called Eric Acuna. Probably in the 90s he came here initially and was part of what we called our STIC program, which is Sector Terminology, Information and Counseling. And his background, I believe, was in engineering, and so he was in our engineering program. And he, through the program, kind of got what he needed in terms of finding work and getting connected to an employer. He was matched up with a mentor. Mentoring is a very big piece of almost all of our programs. And he was successful and got a job in his field and was very happy. And he continued to stay in touch with the organization and eventually became a mentor himself. And a number of years back, he was nominated as the New Pioneer Award recipient for a graduate, the Graduate Award. So he's a really great example of somebody who came in as a client and basically was very successful but has never left. He's really stayed connected to the organization and has been recognized by the organization. And the whole idea behind New Pioneers was that it was really important for us to try to shape positively attitudes towards immigrants and refugees. You hear so many things in the news about difficulties that immigrants and refugees face, and while it's very true, we wanted to celebrate the success stories. There's not really a big distinction for me between, there isn't a distinction between who we are as staff and who we work with as clients, and that I think is what makes us unique, because there isn't, you sometimes hear about a kind of more traditional philanthropic kind of relationship where you have the helpers and the people being helped. And although we do help people, I think we do it in a way that is respectful. There's not a power differential like, oh, you know, I'm the one who can help you, you poor suffering person, you. I mean, there isn't that kind of dynamic. And I think we've created a space here that really is a family. I mean, we often talk about the Skills for Change family, and when we hire new people, the coordinator will send out an email and they always talk about, please help me welcome so-and-so to the Skills for Change family. And many of our staff are immigrants and refugees. I think we really practice what we preach. Like, we really believe our tagline is diversity at work, and we really believe that because it works for us so beautifully.